Today we are going to begin with circular cues. As you can see, some points I have written over here. What are circular cues? So you can see what are circular cues from this diagram. Circular cues are those cues where elements are added, and as elements are deleted, the unused spaces can also be utilized for storing other elements. So in case of a linear queue, as we were saying over here, or I'll explain it to you with the help of another example. In case of a linear queue, the major problem which occurs is that you cannot utilize the space. Suppose I have a fixed sized circular queue, a fixed sized linear queue here, which has the following indices. And over here we go on adding elements. So suppose I add an element over here, this would be marked as front as well as rear. So I go on adding elements over here. So what happens ultimately, this particular element becomes rear. Now when you start deleting elements, that is DQ operation, we know that F just proceeds or gets incremented by 1. So similarly, if I keep on deleting elements, what is happening? Empty space is being created over here. This is the empty space which is created. Now this empty space will not be filled. Why? Because R is already set to size minus 1. Which is at the end, and that is exactly our logic which we have used in the program, that if R is equals to size minus 1, that means we will consider that the queue is full. Hence these two spaces are unused, that is in case of a linear queue. Hence in order to remove all this, or in order to make queues more efficient, what we can do is we can make use of another data structure, that is a circular queue. So in a circular queue, I will just explain to you how it works. So in the circular queue, you can see that first concentrate on this first A part, that is this part. In this part, what can you see? You can see that there is a circular queue. Now this is the logical representation, students. In reality, you cannot represent, sorry, this is the logical view. One second. This is the logical view. In reality, you cannot represent queues in this way. You have to represent queues using either arrays or lists. And both arrays or lists are what? They are linear data structures. Arrays or lists are linear data structures. Got it? They are always represented in the memory in a linear fashion. Now over here, what you can see is, still if I take a logical view, then it would appear something like this. So this is front and this is rear, and this space can be considered as utilized space. It is already utilized. That is, already data values or elements are stored in this part. So what is the unused part? This part is your unused part, which you can use for storing any more elements. Understood? Now come to the second B part over here, the B part of the figure is this part. When at a time elements are added, you can see this is front, which starts from the index 0. Then 1, 2, 3, 4. So 3, 5, 7, 9 and 12 are added, and there are unused spaces left at locations 5, 6, 7 and 8. Okay, so these locations are left empty, that is they can be utilized for storing more elements. Now I will just show it to you. Please be a little patient, students. Now over here, I have to add more elements. Like for example, I have to add 13. Suppose I have to take the element 13, 13. I have inserted the element over here. And over here, my, what is going to be the index? That is 5. So similarly, I can go on inserting elements over here. Now suppose some element is deleted. Some element is deleted from here. How will it work? So in that case, if an element is deleted, it will always be deleted from the front, right? So now your front is going to point to which location? This location, that is one. Front will be pointing to this. Now you go on inserting elements. Suppose I go on inserting elements over here, 60 at location 6. Then I add 85 at location 7. Then I add 90 at location 8. And here, because you deleted one element, this space can be utilized for storing other elements. So now 100 is at which location? 0. So that means our rear will be set to this location. That is, now our rear is what? 100. Front is 5, but rear is what? 100. So another suitable condition you can see over here. In case a queue is full, front is just one more than rear. Front lies just immediately after rear. Understood. Now this is a circular fashion in which you saw your circular queue. We are going to see it in the form of a proper list in case of this. So the case we were taking over here, I am going to delete all the elements right now. So this is the circular queue which I am going to consider. This is your circular queue. And I'm giving the name to it as CQ. Okay. CQ is the name of this circular queue. So now in CQ, what are we going to do? Firstly, if I give some statements over here, in the beginning, of course, front and rear will be set to none. Front is none and rear is also none in the beginning. Right. Now over here, how am I going to actually work in Python? So I'm going to tell you in that sense. Right in the beginning, when you start working, your CQ is empty. That is, it contains what? Just a pair of empty brackets. Okay. So now you have understood the basic concept of circular queue. But we are going to actually see how we will be doing it through our Python program. So now over here in the beginning, CQ is completely blank. So there is nothing in CQ, right? So from here, I can give, there arises one situation, that is, I'm just writing all the possible conditions here. I'll be writing those conditions also so that while we actually, when we actually start with our program for circular queue, things are not difficult for you. Understood? So we are going to do it that way. So if I write here, when everything is blank, there is nothing in CQ. So how do I understand that? I can simply write here, if CQ is blank, we need to do something for this. So what we need to do is, what we would be doing if CQ is blank, the very first thing which I am going to do is set front to 0 and rear also to 0. Why? Because I cannot add anything to none. None is a data type which doesn't support any kind of arithmetic operation. Hence, I have to set both of them to 0 right when your program starts. Okay. Once everything is set to 0, I have to add element to this. So how do I add element to CQ? I will write CQ plus equal to item. Either I can write this or I can write CQ dot append item. Which either one you can use. So that way, now suppose the first element which is added to your CQ was, I'll be giving the statements here. First step NQ. A, one element to be added, that is A. So in that case, what will happen? Now CQ is no longer blank and it contains at least one element, that is A at location 0. A is there at which location? That is 0 and front and rear are also set to 0, 0. So front is set to 0 and rear is also set to 0. Both are set to 0. Understood? Now in the next case, now what can be done? We can go on adding elements, but here we have to consider one more thing, that is size. Usually circular cues have a fixed size. That is the reason why the concept of reusing unused spaces arises, because size is limited, hence we need to utilize every space. Just think about a situation. Had it been that a circular cue could have allowed unlimited number of elements, do you think we would have needed the requirement, we would have come across the requirement for utilizing unused spaces? I don't think so. We need to utilize unused spaces only when the size space is limited. So here the size is already considered as 5. Understood? That is, at most we can insert only 5 elements in the circular cue. In programming languages like C, C++, Java and all, which supports arrays as data structures, arrays usually have a restriction. That is, right in the beginning we have to provide the size of the array. That is, maximum number of elements which can be stored in the array. Understood? Unlike the lists of Python. In Python, we don't need to specify any maximum limit for lists. Understood? Lists can contain any unlimited number of elements. So we have to make use of that unlimited feature also, and the limitation of circular cue both. That amalgamation of these two things, it becomes quite tricky over here. So please follow this very carefully. So over here, one element has been added over here. Size is 5. Suppose your array is already full. What will happen in that case? This is the case when your array is full. Now size is 5. Hence, I'm going to remove this last one. So in case the array is full, what to do in that case? If you delete any element, now technically speaking, front will be set to 0 and rear will be set to 4. If you delete any element in case of circular queue, you will not be using the pop function. That is, you will not be physically removing A from here. Only thing which you will be doing is just increment the value of F. So this space, this A space, this space will remain unused. Unused, or this may point to what? A space which can be reused or replaced. This value can be replaced, or it can show, or it can denote an invalid Q element. A Q element which doesn't exist. Understood? So this is what we are going to follow over here. So in that case, what will happen? This particular space A can be reused by another element. So I can write here what? F. And over here, I will remove R from here, and this will be my new R. This is my idea what we are going to do. So now in case, now this is only possible in this case, what we can do? We cannot add any element using CQ plus equal to item. In that case, we will have to use, in that case, we have to do this, that is CQ, whatever is there at your element location, that is CQ 0 is equal to item we have to write. Now this particular thing is only possible, when your queue is already full, or when your list is already full. Don't forget that we are using lists in order to implement circular queues. So this is only possible when already that particular location, it contains an element and you are trying to replace that. Got it? That replacement has to be done, and sometimes what is to be done? Elements have to be added. Now remember one thing, elements have to be added only when number of elements in CQ is not equal to the size. Got it? That is our first case which we handle, that is A. And right now what we are going to do is, this is my Q right now. F and R are both set to this. So अभी जब ऐसा है दैट इज ऑल द अदर पोजिशंस ऑल द अदर लोकेशंस आर एम्प्टी वी कैनॉट यूज दिस स्टेटमेंट वी कैनॉट यूज दिस स्टेटमेंट सॉरी वी कैनॉट यूज दिस स्टेटमेंट बिकॉज इफ आई ट्राई टू असाइन एनीथिंग एट द सेकेंड लोकेशन आई विल बी यूजिंग दिस स्टेटमेंट सी क्यू वन इक्वल्स आइटम Now, what is there in one? There is no index with one. Python will give you index out of range error here. Hence, so as to not encounter this particular error, what we will be doing is we would be checking something over here. What we will be checking? If the length of CQ is equal to size if the number of elements in CQ is equal to the size that is if length of CQ is 5 that is it contains 5 elements and the limit of your circular queue is also 5 in that means your queue is already full it contains a b c d e 0 1 2 3 4 okay so in that case we will be using this statement Now we have to add one more element over there. So what we will be doing, we know that when adding elements, only rear is changed. So we will be incrementing rear by one. We will not be making any changes to front. CQ rear is equals to item. This is what we are going to do in that case. When number of elements, when your queue is already full and we are trying to use the unused space. So we are not going to delete any elements over there once they are added. But in case when the size, when your length of CQ is not equal to size, in that case, what we will be doing, we will simply be writing it this way. CQ plus equal to item or CQ dot append item because now we are creating spaces, allocating spaces over here and we will be writing rear plus equal to one. So in this case, now what will happen? Another element will be added. So another element is added at location one and rear is what it is now pointing to one and front is pointing to zero. Now, as according to my statement, what we are going to do, we are till the time how and out of these three conditions, condition one, condition two, and condition three, which of these three will be executed? Out of these three conditions, which condition will be executed? And what will be the status of the queue and the front and rear? We are going to execute the third condition because length of CQ is only 2 whereas size is 5. So first condition, let us check, is CQ empty? No. Is length of CQ equal to size? No. That means we come to the else part. That is CQ plus equal to item. What is the item? B. So already I have inserted B over here. Rear, firstly, this statement will be executed. That is item will be, or you can write rear plus one equal to plus equal to one before CQ also. That's not a problem. So first I entered the element, then I incremented the value of rear. This is my queue status right now. Okay. I'm giving one more question. NQC. My question is, you have to insert one more element C and give me the same answer, that is status of CQ and which condition will be executed. Correct answer, third. What will be the status of the queue? Of CQ is 2. And what is size? 5. Good. So is length, pehle to ye batao, is CQ empty? First condition execute hoga kya? No. Okay. Come to the second one. Second condition satisfy ho raha hai kya? No. So that means we come to which condition? Obviously, third condition. Okay. In third condition, now what is the first statement? CQ plus equal to item means what will happen in this? Hence, it will take up the index as and what will happen? Rear plus equal to one. So one will be added to rear. So now rear is set at two. Similarly, when I give another statement here, NQ, D and E, I'm adding two more elements here. So D will be added here, E will be added here, and over here it will be 3 and 4. So this is done and rear is set to what? 4. Now I'm giving one more question. I write NQF. What will happen? If length of CQ is equal to size rear plus equal to 1, can I insert more elements than size? What this is going to do is rear plus 1, it will do. Rear plus 1 is what? It is going to be 5, which is not there in the list right now. If I write rear plus equal to 1, it is giving me an additional location here, 5, which is not there in the list right now. And if I try to write CQ rear equal to item, Python is going to give me an error, that is list index out of range. If I try to insert one more element over here, I cannot do that using the second condition. Why? Because rear plus 1 will give me what? 5. Fine. And there is no element in the list which contains index 5. So this will give you what type of an error? Index out of range error. Hence, you can see that already the size of the queue is 5. And the length of the queue is also what? 5. Fine. And I have not yet deleted any element from here. That is, I have not proceeded or incremented the value of F such that the zeroth position is available. So none of the positions are available. All the elements are valid elements. In this case, it should be a queue is full condition. That is queue overflow condition. So out of the, there are two overflow conditions in case of circular queue, out of which we are seeing the first one. Got it? So if front is set to 0 and rear is set to size minus 1, in that case, your queue is full. So when you try to insert F over here, it will give you overflow. If I delete any element, now popping or deleting, we will be seeing in DQ, which we will be doing in the subsequent classes. But today, what I'm going to tell you, suppose an element is now deleted because you have to make space in the queue. So DQ is there, say DQ one element. So in that case, what will happen? One element will be deleted from the queue. So over here, when one element is deleted from here, we are going to simply increment the value of 1, increment the value of F. We will not pop A. A rahega list mein. But the valid part of the queue would be considered as this part. This will be considered as the valid part, whereas A will be considered as the invalid part of the queue. This red color suggests that A is what? An invalid part of the queue. That is, this particular space, it can be reused. This space can be reused. So this part can be reused. Now I have to insert one more element over here. So this part I have to reuse. Now you can see over here that front is greater than 0. It is not set to 0 anymore. And rear is already at size minus 1. So come here comes the fifth condition. If front is greater than 0 and rear is equal to size minus 1, I cannot obviously increment the value of R to 5. I have to set the value to which value to reuse this position of A. Pehle aap rear ko kya karoge? 0 karoge. The moment rear reaches size minus 1, you will reset rear to 0. Yes. So rear will be reset to 0. So rear yahan aa jayega. And whatever element you want to add. Ab maine yahan pe kya likha tha? NQ. Aur mujhe kuch element add karna hai. So I wrote, I will insert the value of F now. Earlier it was giving me overflow because all the positions were valid positions. So now I will insert F. And now this is going to be which position? It is going to be the valid position. So rear will be pointing to 0 and F will be pointing to 1. So now if elements start, if I write here DQ1, that is delete one element, which element will be deleted? Correct answer is B. That is, if I say DQ delete one element, what will be deleted? B will be deleted. But right now we are not doing that. Why? Because I want to show you one more condition, alternative condition of queue is full. One condition was this, and the other one would be or front equals rear plus 1. You can see over here what is front? It is 1. And what is rear? It is 0. So front is equals to rear plus 1, 0 plus 1 is 1. So anytime you encounter this condition, that is front is just immediately after rear. पहले रियर है उसके तुरंत बाद फ्रंट है. दैट मीन्स देर इज नो रूम फॉर न्यू एलिमेंट्स इन द क्यू इज कंप्लीटली फुल. अंडरस्टूड दिस? वी हैव टेकन द फर्स्ट कंडीशन हियर, दैट इज सी क्यू. इफ इट इज कंप्लीटली एम्प्टी, सेट बोथ फ्रंट एंड रियर टू जीरो एंड एड एन एलिमेंट इन टू इट. ओके, सेकेंड वन, Q is full. If front is 0, rear is size minus 1, front equals rear plus 1. So Q is full. Next condition, if there is room in the beginning, front is greater than 0 and rear is equal to size minus 1, rear is set rear to 0, because once rear reaches size minus 1, and if there is room in the beginning, you have to again reset rear back to 0, add element this way. That is CQ rear equals item. That is, now we will only be replacing the elements, not deleting anything from the queue. Else is case of insertion, that is your this condition, these two conditions, second and third condition. So in that case, what was happening is we will of course write rear plus equal to 1. That would be common to both. If length of CQ is less than size, that is CQ doesn't contain enough elements. So that in that case, we will append element. And if already element is there, we will only replace that. And finally, we are going to return what? Front and rear. Students, today, this is your NQ, which we have discussed over here. What is the difference between arrays and lists? The difference between arrays and lists is, arrays have a fixed size. That is, in C++, we normally declare arrays this way. For example, I have to declare the CQ. So I'll have to take a maximum size for this. Say I take the maximum size as 100, or I take the maximum size as 5. I cannot leave it blank. This is the limitation of arrays. In arrays, I have to specifically give the number of elements, and whereas in case of lists in Python, there is no such limitation that you have to provide the maximum number of elements in the list. Moreover, lists in Python can grow dynamically, can grow and shrink dynamically. That is, you add an element, you append an element to it, it will grow. That is, it will increase, the number of indices or places will increase. And the moment you pop an element or remove or delete any element, it will decrease. So list automatically maintains the structure of your elements there. And also one more thing, in case of arrays, if you are deleting something, suppose we have arrays like this. A, B, C, D, E, and they have positions marked this way. So these positions are going to be fixed. That is, we don't have any function like pop or delete or remove in case of arrays. There is no such function available, right? So what will happen if you have to delete any element? You cannot delete that until, and you can only replace the elements in case of arrays. तो अगर आप CQ को इम्प्लीमेंट कर रहे हैं थ्रू एरेज, सो इन दैट केस व्हाट विल हैपन, यू कैन ओनली गो ऑन इंक्रीमेंटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ एफ एंड रीयूजिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ द प्रीवियस एलिमेंट्स. सो दैट यू कैन डू. एंड ऑल्सो इफ यू हैव डिलीटेड दिस एफ, इफ यू हैव डिलीटेड टू एलिमेंट्स, राइट, एंड दीज एलिमेंट्स वर ए एंड बी, सो दीज स्पेसेस आर कंसिडर्ड एज इनवैलिड, बट दे आर स्टिल देयर इन द मेमोरी. वो मेमोरी से हटते नहीं है, और आप, देयर इज नो वे दैट यू कैन डिलीट दीज टू पोजिशंस. वेयर एज इन केस ऑफ पाइथन व्हाट विल हैपन, इट विल रिमूव दीज एलिमेंट्स, ये रिमूव भी करेगा, एंड इट इज ऑटोमेटिकली गोइंग टू रीसेट द इंडाइसेस ऑल्सो. ओके, if one first element is deleted, the second element automatically becomes the first element in case of lists, but that doesn't happen in arrays. So I have already created the menu driven part of the program here. everything is, I think, very, you can understand the things here. In the first line, I have assigned an empty list to circular queue. This is going to be the queue which contains all my elements. In the second line, front and rear are set to none. The third line, size has been asked from the user, because circular queue works on the principle of fixed sized lists. Okay, that is the reason why utilizing the space, this concept comes into existence. Dequeue one element, remove one element. That means which element will be removed now? Obviously, front will be removed. So over here, what will happen? Front will not be removed. Nothing will be removed. Only thing, front will be incremented by one. So it becomes two now. And I'll just, yes. So this is my, now this particular area would be marked as invalid. That is, there is still room for one element in the queue. I will again give you an NQ question. NQH. Now you tell me what will be executed. NQH is there. Is rear equal to size minus 1? No. Rear is 0. Front is greater than 0, but rear is 0. So this condition is not true.
A fifth condition.
Not the fifth condition, my dear. Fourth condition. If length of CQ is equal to size, check the length of CQ. All the elements are intact in the list. If you just see it in the form of a list, all elements are already there. Length of CQ is 5 and size is also 5. So rear will be incremented by 1. That means now rear becomes this. And now this area will be marked as valid area, and you can replace it. What will we writing here? H. Okay. So CQ rear equals item. First you incremented rear over here. Rear plus equal to 1. And then CQ 1 equals item. So only it got replaced. Understood this, everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
This is how insertions take place in case of circular queue. Okay. So now what we are going to do is we are going to see the program for NQ of circular queue. We were declaring the function. It's going to take 5 arguments: CQ, front, rear, item, and size. So over here, first thing which we are going to check is whether the queue is empty or not. If CQ is empty, empty CQ, then what is going to happen? Front and rear will be set to none, sorry, 0. And CQ plus equal to item. Or you can write CQ dot append item, it's up to you. So one element is added. L if, second condition was the overflow condition. So if front is equals to 0 and rear is equals to size minus 1, or front is equals to rear plus 1, that means CQ overflow. So we will print what CQ is full. Elif. Our third condition, if front is 0, front is greater than 0, and rear is equals to size minus 1, so in that case, rear will be equal set to 0 and CQ rear will be set to item. Now, in the last, what is our last? So this last case, we will be making it as a nested if. Else, if you can make it as cascaded elif also, and I'm making, but I'm doing it as nested if. So in this case, first we will check if length of CQ is equal to size. That is, list CQ is already full. Physically, not logically, we are seeing it physically. So in that case, what you will be doing is rear plus equal to 1, and you will be writing CQ rear is equals to item. Else you will be simply writing rear plus equals to 1 and CQ plus equals to item. Now you can see two statements are common over here. That is, rear plus one is common. So what I'll do is I will remove it from here and I will simply put it in the beginning. And I'll remove it from here. So this is what I did. And in the end, I'm going to return front and rear. These things are going to get returned now. If it is full and this one would be list CQ is not equal to size. And for displaying the queue, right now I am only going to use this line, that is, I'm simply going to write here print CQ. Print CQ, and I'm also going to print the value of front and rear. Front and rear. And same thing I can write in peak also. So our work will be. So now over here, we'll run the program and see. Enter size 5. Okay, I did a mistake, and that mistake is, so what the problem which we faced is, which we are facing over here is, I did not call this function and neither did I pass item to the function. So what I'm going to do is, first I'm going to ask for item. Enter the element. And now over here, what is it? What all things are there? I'll simply copy this line and I'm going to paste it over here. But is this enough? Because what is being returned? A tuple is being returned over here. Tuple is returned. So when a tuple is returned, I had already explained it before, it has to be accepted in the form of a tuple. So tuple CQ is equals to this, and now we can extract front from this and rear from this. So this is it, and I'm going to print the values also, and I'm going to print, what I'm going to do is this CQ, I'm going to print it even after this. That is NQ. That will save our time. Now let us see. Sorry, I did a mistake. I had to give 5 as the size. Yes, so one element has been added. Second element has been added, and you can see how front and rear are changing. And now it gives me Q is full, because the Q is, the front is set to 0 and rear is set to size minus 1. One of the conditions for overflow. Okay, so we have completed this much. Now we will be discussing about DQ. So we come back over here and we start discussing about DQ. So I will delete these statements. And I'm going to delete these items also. This is our queue as of now. So we are going to take this queue into consideration. The very first thing which we are going to check is whether the queue is empty or not. So I'll write, if CQ is empty, what should be my statement? It means there is overflow. That is, I cannot add anything to it. CQ is empty, that is, there is nothing to delete, hence the queue is already empty. Sorry, not overflow, it should be queue is empty. There is nothing to delete. Come to the second condition over here. In the second condition, it might be possible that there is only one element into the queue, right? So, but we will be taking this one. Yes, there is only one element in the queue. So we will take that a little later. First, we'll see queue dq over here. So I first write here dq one element. So when I write dq one element, what should happen? Front should be simply incremented by one. So that case is, I will simply write front plus equal to one. Okay, and before doing this, I will save the item first. So item equals CQ front. First, I will save whatever is there in CQ front, and then I'm going to increment front by one. So over here, when I am saving the element, what is the element being saved? That is C. And front will be set to the next one, and this area would be set as invalid. That is, it's an empty space, and it can be used to replace, it can be replaced by a new item. That is, there is room in your queue. Third case could be, now this way I go on deleting elements. So I delete this element also, it becomes red, and now front becomes what? Four. So now front is this four. Okay. So now front is at the end. So if I delete front from here, if I delete this element, then what should be front? Now if I delete front from here, what should happen? Once zero. Front reaches, you might have undergone this case in case of NQ, when rear reaches the end point and there is room in the beginning. You set rear to zero. So here also what we will be doing is we will be setting front to zero. Okay, so we will see that. So when is that condition? If I see that front is equals to size minus one. If front is equals to size minus one, then in that case what will happen? I will write front equals zero. But before writing that, I will save item first. Whatever is there in front, and then I will set front to zero. So now what will happen? E, D has already has been taken out. E has been taken out. E will be set as invalid location. Front will be set to F. So now front is what? Front is zero. Our queue is still not empty, it still contains elements. So now over here, I give you one more statement. If I have to again DQ, I say DQ one element. Out of these three conditions, which one will be executed? Firstly, if I check the first condition, is CQ empty? No. Come to the next one. Come to the third one actually. I'll keep this one in the end, because here there is no condition, so that can be considered as else part. So over here, I'll come to the second condition over here. Let me take this as the last condition for the time being. So is front equal to size minus one? No. So come to the last part, that is front should be incremented by one as usual. So over here, front will become one. That is, now front becomes this one. And F is taken out, and now F becomes what? Invalid location. So now your queue contains how many elements? Only one element. So in this case, when I again give you the command DQ1, now what should happen? there is only one element into your queue. Now if I delete these two elements, sorry, if I delete this element, what should happen? I should clear the entire queue, set it to a blank list. I should set front and rear back to none. So for that, I will be adding another case over here. I'll shift this. I will be adding a third case here, and this case is going to become my fourth case. If front is equal to rear. If front is equal to rear, you can see that every time there is only one element in the queue, it will be both front as well as rear. So if that is the case, first step, yes, so only one element is there. So that was what I was speaking about. If front is equal to rear, then first thing, we are going to save whatever is there in front, and then we are going to set front equals front comma rear equals none and none. That is, both front and rear will be set to none, and CQ will be again made into an empty list. So now CQ is again ready to accept elements. So over here, what will happen? I will set both of them to none. So now both front and rear are gone because they are set to none. Okay, this element is saved. And entire queue is deleted. So now the queue is again empty. Okay, did you all understand this part? Let us see the program now. Okay. NQ we had already discussed. We are going to discuss what? CQ. Sorry, DQ. We are going to pass CQ. Front, rear, and size over here. Function to delete elements from CQ. Now, very first thing, I'm going to first set item equals none. In case your queue is already empty, there is nothing to delete, then what will happen? At least item should have a none value so that when it comes back to main, there is some way to understand that there is nothing to delete in the queue. So if CQ, the first condition, if CQ is empty, empty CQ. So we are going to print over here, Q is empty. Elif, what was our second condition? That is, if front is equals to size minus one. Or it's better if we take this condition, that is, if front is equal to rear, that is only one element in the queue. Why we are doing this is because if we take this condition first, if front equals size minus one, suppose the condition is like this, that is, you have A, B, C, D, E. These are the statements here. These are the elements in the queue. And your front is already set here. And your rear is set over here. So if we are doing this, then front will be set. If suppose this is the case, that is, only one element is there. This is front as well as this is rear. All these areas are invalid areas, invalid locations. And this is the only valid location. So in that case, what will happen? This case, this particular condition will be satisfied and it will work wrongly. Item will be saved, but front will be set to zero, which we don't want. That is the reason why we have to set the next condition, that is third condition, before the second condition. So if this is the case, first of all, save the item, which is already there in the queue at front. Set front and rear both to none and set CQ as an empty list. Next, if front is equals to size minus one, if this is the case now. front reaches end of list, sorry, rear end of list, hence has to be reset to zero. So in this case, again, save the item which is there and set front to zero. So now front will be set to zero. And if this is also not true, that means the last case where item should be saved first and front will only be simply be incremented by one. Once this is done, we are going to return three values: item, front, and rear. Return double. Let us check whether this program is working or not, but for that I'll have to make changes here. That is, I will write tuple cq is, I will copy this function prototype or function header, and I will see what all values are returned: item, front, and rear. So first thing to be returned is item. So I will write here item equals tuple cq0, second one front, third one rear. Front is the equals to first second element of the tuple, and rear equals to third element of the tuple. And what I can do is simply print these two. Let us print the list and print the value of front and rear. Let us run the program and see the answer. So here we are getting Q is full, and now we start with DQ. So the element which has been deleted is not being printed. So I need to print the element which is deleted also. So for that reason, what I'm going to do is over here, I have to add right in the beginning element deleted is. What is the element deleted? It is item. So let us see again. We add some random elements here. Fine. Now I start DQ. Element deleted is AA, but this will be displayed. Why it will be displayed? Because it is being displayed as a list. We have written print CQ. So print CQ AAA is not physically deleted from the list. It is only marked as invalid. So I'm just marking this as invalid. This is invalid. It's already deleted. Your front is now what? 1 and rear is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Again, when I delete element from here, next element to be deleted is BB. So that means now the elements which are deleted are these two. Okay. Next, when I write CCC is deleted, but I want to insert another element. So I will insert FFF and see, you can see over here that there was already space here. Three elements were deleted. These three areas were already invalid areas. These three were invalid areas. So now what happened? What are the invalid areas? These two are the invalid areas, whereas this is the valid data, this is valid data, this is valid data. Front is 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, and rear is set to 0. Now, again, I insert another element into it. So you can see over here what is deleted. Now, CCC, this is the only invalid data over here. And again, I'm going to insert one more element over here. And over here, you can see there are no invalid regions. You can see front is 1 more than rear. So here we can check that under overflow condition also, if I give another value, so you can see Q is full. And similarly, if I go on removing the elements now, DQ, so DDD is deleted. That means this is my invalid data. Again, I delete another element, EEE is also deleted. So we have these two as invalid data. Okay, and let me now again write DQ. So FFF is deleted and front is 1 and rear is 2. So over here, what is the invalid? What are the invalid elements? FFF is the invalid element over here. Front is 1. That means front is 1 and rear is 2. That means except these elements, GGG and HHH are valid elements. So I will again press DQ. So GGG is also deleted now. That means now we have only one valid data, that is H. H is the only valid data. H is the only valid data over here. Next, again, I press DQ. So now you can see both front and rear are set to none. HHH is also deleted. So this entire list is now completely blank. Let us see if anything else can be deleted. Okay, front is still there. That is, it did not set the list to blank. So for this, what you can do is, but here I think I missed on a statement. So this is Gargi signing off. Thank you all.